Welcome to the first video in a series about how to perform a completely new installation of the Cencon software. Using the newest version of Cencon will ensure full functionality with all Cencon Gen 2 locks and keys. In addition, several new features have been added. Security has been enhanced and the software optimized. In these four videos, I'll show you step by step, click by click, how to perform a completely new installation of the Cencon software. In this first video, we'll talk about contents of the Cencon software package, review system requirements, install a SQL database management system, and gather important information that we'll use later during the installation process. The Cencon server license kit contains several items. I'm going to list each of these items for you. There's an installation CD, Cencon single server license certificate, software getting started guide, one set of quick reference cards, Cencon software maintenance and support agreement form, one change key, and a total of 7 Cencon smart keys. Now these 7 Cencon smart keys consist of the following: 2 red supervisor keys, 3 black logon keys, 1 white clock set key, which is for our generation 2 locks, and 1 gray resync key, which is also for our generation 2 locks.
There will also be one or more mode authorization licenses. Bank mode includes 2 green bank mode keys. FLM mode includes 2 blue FLM mode keys. And route mode includes 2 yellow route mode keys.
A Cencon installation key is included too.
This orange key is programmed for installation. It's uniquely coded and tagged per company. It's packaged and shipped separately for security reasons. A Cencon dispatch kit contains a Cencon USB key box, which is uniquely coded per company, as well as a USB cable.
For the rest of this first video, we'll talk about system requirements. For the Cencon software to operate correctly, you'll need a computer with a Windows operating system. The supported operating systems are listed here. Additionally, you'll need 2 gigabytes of RAM, 250 megabytes of hard drive space, and a USB 2.0 or higher connection. A Cencon key box is required along with a SQL database management system. For the Cencon software to work, a SQL database management system must be installed. Examples are listed here. For these videos, we use Microsoft SQL Server Express 2008 R2 and SQL Server Management Studio. Before we start, be certain you have a valid Orange install key and are thinking about a 4-digit company ID. Both of these are very important. For the rest of this first video, we'll gather some important information.
After logging onto the computer with administrative rights, the first thing to do is check the date and time. Click the Start button, and then click on Control Panel. Once the Control Panel window opens, click on the Date and Time icon and verify the date, time, and time zone are correct. It's important to note that the date and time on the computer with Cencon installed must be within 15 minutes of the time on the SQL server. Otherwise, the Cencon software will not work. Let's perform a Windows update to be sure the operating system and database management system are up to date. Let's go back to the Control Panel window. Click Windows Update and click on Check Online for updates from Microsoft Update. If any updates were installed, restart the computer now.
That concludes our first video. You now know the contents of the Cencon package and the system requirements to run the Cencon software. You've installed a SQL database management system and collected information that will be used later in the upgrade process. In the next video, we'll show you how to install the native client driver and create a new ODBC connection.